the offseason, you told another outlet that this was a dream come true for you to be with the Spurs. Can you take us through that, why that is?
Yeah, I mean, the Spurs is obviously, they've been, you know, pretty good my whole life. You know, it was a team that my grandpa really liked watching, and my grandma as well. So, you know, ever since then, I kind of had, like, you know, just interest in the Spurs and, you know, the way they play basketball. I mean, going up throughout high school and whatnot, obviously the stuff that Coach Pop teaches and instills in the team, you know, my high school team also implemented, you know, so.
Was your grandpa from around here or just?
No, I think he just liked winners, you know. He liked watching a team that won a lot, and, you know, so I think that's probably why.
So what's your first initial experience with Pop been like so far?
It's been great. You know, obviously, you know, being my fourth year in the league now, they kind of expect more out of me as far as, you know, knowing a lot of the stuff that he's already teaching the young guys. But he's been great. You know, he's been challenging us, making us just be more professional as players, and it's been good.
If you would take us through the summer, how you got here, did you expect to be let go by OKC? Did you expect the Spurs to just grab you off waivers?
No, I didn't really expect to get let go from OKC, to be honest. But, you know, I think once I was let go, I was hoping that I would go to a team that one was, you know, that liked me throughout the draft process and, you know, throughout my career so far. So, you know, I was really happy to get picked up by the Spurs.
Were you kind of hoping you'd get to the create, like, clear waivers and you could pick your team, or?
I mean, honestly, for me, you know, it's a blessing either way. You know, every opportunity in the NBA is a blessing. And so, you know, when I was picked up, it was a kind of a nerve-wracking 20 or 48 hours. Yeah. But once I got the good news, I was coming to San Antonio, I was happy.
How does this situation compare to OKC? Because they're two of the three youngest teams. Is it kind of the same vibe?
It's very similar as far as, like, you know, as far as having young guys who have to learn the NBA game. You know, it's totally different from college. You know, Blake, Jeremy, and Malachi, you know, they were great college players, but, you know, it's a different level now. So that was really similar. Last year in OKC, we had a lot of teenagers. You know, on this team, we have a few teenagers too. So it's definitely similar in that respect, but, you know, I'm definitely excited for the challenge.
You were familiar with the Spurs in the pre-draft process and in your draft? They were on you?
Yeah, they were my first workout. I came back, I actually worked out for the Spurs twice. So, you know, I had good workouts here and, you know, was able to meet some of the coaches and the front office members.
What position do you think you fill there? If I remember correctly, I think you played some small ball five against them last year.
Yeah, for sure.
Kicked their butt a little bit.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I think I could play. You know, honestly, I think I can guard all positions on the court. You know, in Oklahoma City, we ran small ball five a lot, and I was, you know, the primary at the five. But I think here, you know, being able to play alongside Jakob and Zach will be awesome for my game and for the team.
What's your ideal spot?
Probably four. You know, I think a switching four who can, you know, switch on all different types of guards defensively and offensively, you know, exploit mismatches and, you know, push the ball off the break when I get a rebound, that type of, that's really important to my game.
You mentioned this is only your fourth season.
Yeah.
OKC, you was the young pup. Now you're here, you're one of the older players. What's that like for you?
It's crazy, but, you know, I got a lot of time under my belt in the league, minutes, game minutes, and, you know, obviously practice minutes. So, you know, I think that the coaches are just looking to expect more out of me from, you know, even though I'm 24. Same thing with, you know, KJ and Devin too. You know, we've had a lot of minutes under our belt, so they expect more out of us.
You talk about the coaches' expectations and your teammates' expectations. What are your expectations coming into this season?
Yeah, just improve. You know, every year, I think if you look at my numbers, I improved every year. Every year became a more consistent player, more efficient player, and that's what I'm just going to keep on doing.
That
jump shot looked good, man. Is that what you've been really focused on this offseason?
For sure. I mean, you know, in today's league, everybody can shoot, but I think there's, you know, there's different levels still. There's guys that can, you know, separate themselves and, you know, challenge the defense in different ways that they can really shoot the ball, and that's what I'm trying to do.
That's what I was going to ask. Are you going to have a higher volume of three-point shooting, you think?
For sure. I think that in my first couple of years, you know, battling just, you know, battling confidence with my shot, battling, you know, where to find your shots. You know, in the NBA, you can't really turn down open shots, and open shots don't really feel open sometimes, but you gotta be able to get that shot off quick and, you know, have a quick release on your jump shot. So that's what I've been working on.
It's still really early, but have you been able to sort of gauge how your style of play fits in with what the Spurs like to do on both
for
sides
sure.
of the ball?
Yeah, for sure. I think, you know, I think defensively, obviously, you know, hard-nosed team, team defense, and, you know, just being a vocal leader. That's kind of what, on OKC, that was my role. I was kind of the quarterback of the defense. You know, here I like to do the same thing. Offensively, you know, they're giving us the free rein to just, you know, pretty much everybody can grab the rebound and push the break, which is awesome. It'll be good for, you know, causing mismatches on defense. And, you know, I'm looking forward to just playing a versatile style of basketball.
In this offseason, you had your annual camp out in Lincoln, Nebraska. Mm-hmm. Is that something you plan on continuing to do? And if you do, why is it so important for you to get back to your alma mater city?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, it's something I plan to do every year, every summer. It's been getting bigger, and you know, we see this summer we saw a lot of new faces and a lot of old faces returning. You know, I think it's big time for somebody like me who's just getting started in the league. I can't really donate my money, but I can donate my time, and I can, you know, go reach out to the kids and, you know, teach them a little something about basketball.
Is there anyone on the roster that you knew well before?
Me and Joe grew up in the same area, kind of. You know, he's from about, you know, an hour and a half on the Iowa side of the Illinois-Iowa border. I'm about an hour and a half on the Illinois side. So we've worked out together before. Obviously played against him at Iowa, played against Romeo at Indiana, and you know, so we got a lot of Big Ten guys outside of that, but not really. But, you know, I've competed against a lot of these guys, so it's, you know, it's fun being in the locker room with them.